第一位请李海伦小姐，佢系会用英语发问啊发言嘅，李小姐。
As one of the last people to speak, I would not be surprised if I'm one of the first to mention the real people that are being hurt in this situation, those that want and need their driver's license. When I first decided to talk about this issue, the first person that came to mind was a friend of mine that took 9 months to get her license. This is not a flaw on her behalf, but due to the shortages of instructors. I turn to the street and I look at the father working a hard job on minimum wage. He was a secondary school dropout and now all he wants to do is improve himself to help support his family. With little qualifications, he tries to become a driver in order to earn more money. He too must wait to get his license. Time after time, delay after delay, and he cannot even get his license. If it took my friend 9 months to get her license, how long will it take him and how long will his family have to struggle? When I think about my experiences back home, I think about how easy it was for me. One phone call and I got my lesson. 2 to 3 months later, I got my test. Comparing this to my friend, she had to wait 3 times that amount. Hong Kong has placed a restriction on the number of private driving instructors out there. This limit is just an arbitrary number created for the vested interests of someone else. Standing before me, I see those that want their voices to be heard. Why is there even a restriction to the amount of licenses issued? Who determines this arbitrary number? How is it even determined? What will happen after people get their lessons? Are there even enough licensing centres available for testing? These are the questions I impose. It is ironic that the government places such great emphasis on increasing the value of ourselves, or in Cantonese, ji or junjik, yet they refuse people the simple right to get their license without a great delay. If a driver instructor is competent, safe, and can pass the test, why should he be unable to teach that group of vehicle? It is these barriers that become the issue, and it is these barriers that need to be eradicated to fix the actual issue. We are here so that father, that friend, or that colleague can get the license they need. I personally know someone who has been affected by this, and it's for that reason I stand before you. The Lion Rock Institute demands to open up the market now and welcomes the Legislative Council, government officials, and anyone else to contact the Lion Rock Institute.
Thank you.